This is breaking news on WDSU.
That's right. We begin this morning with major breaking news. Police are on the scene of a mass shooting along Canal Street in New Orleans. The NOPD says shots rang out around 4 a.m. And right now, 10 people have been shot and injured, all due to gunfire. Let's go straight to our reporter on the scene, Michael Vincenot, with the latest breaking developments. Michael, this just happened about 2 hours ago. What's it look like right now?
Hey there, Travers. That's right. Police say this happened around 3:20 this morning. I want to step out of the way and show you guys what's happening right now. You can see police are still investigating around this McDonald's here in between St. Charles and Carondelet on Canal Street. And if you look at the ground there, there are dozens of markers that police usually put down signaling evidence here on the scene. But back to what we know so far, police say around 3:20 this morning, police officers near the scene actually heard the gunfire. They thought they were being shot at. They hurried to the scene and said they found multiple individuals. Now, at this point in time, we know there are 10 people that have been shot this morning, two of which are in critical condition. Now, those folks were taken to the local hospitals, and we do not know any more information about who they are and their ages. But we do know that Louisiana State Police and New Orleans Police are working together here at the scene, a very active scene. I spoke to a witness a few moments ago who said they heard dozens of gunshots just a few hours ago here on Canal Street this morning.
Wrong place, wrong time. I just pray for the family. Hope everybody okay.
And again, still a very active scene. Again, this shooting happened just around 2 hours ago at 3:20 this morning. See, police are still investigating. But again, Travers, we know that 10 people have been shot, two of which are in critical condition. Back to you.
Michael, it's a busy tourism weekend in the city of New Orleans. Do they know how many people were on Canal Street? And do they know when that area could reopen? Obviously, it's going to be a busy Sunday morning with people waking up to news of this mass shooting.
Yeah, that's right. And there are still a lot of people out here right now. Not a lot of people are saying they know exactly what happened. Not that they didn't hear it, they didn't see it. But speaking of how many people are in the area, and those folks might want to avoid this area. You see, this block right here is blocked off, but also a few blocks away, police are stopping traffic so folks can't get into this area at several of the intersections. So again, if you can avoid this area at all costs, please do so. This is the 700 block of Canal Street in between Carondelet and St. Charles. So again, folks, if you don't need to be in this area, try to avoid it, because you're gonna have to deal with some serious traffic.
All right, Michael Vincenot live on the scene. Carondelet and St. Charles on the uptown side, Bourbon and Royal if you're on the French Quarter side. Now, we should point out that just 3 years ago, the scene, much the same in the area where downtown meets the French Quarter. Take a look at this. 10 people were shot, one killed on November 27th, 2016, the Sunday morning after the Thanksgiving holiday. That shooting happened in the 200 block of Bourbon Street near Canal. Several bars actually captured the aftermath on surveillance video. Two men were arrested for that incident. And 15 years ago on this weekend, back in 2004, several people were shot in the 100 block of Bourbon Street. Just to recap, here's what we know right now. 10 people shot and injured on Bourbon Street. The shooting happened just after 3 a.m., between 3 and 4 a.m. in the morning. Police say they had officers in that block. They actually thought they were being shot at, and they ran to the scene. Right now, police are not giving a motive for the shooting. They do have a person in custody, but they're not saying if that person is actually related to this incident. For more on this, let's go live to security expert Mike Kahn, who's joining us on the phone. Mike, a developing situation here. Police were just feet away from this situation. How do they go about investigating a crime like this? Will surveillance video be the key?
Absolutely. So anytime you have something like this in such a highly compacted area, that particular McDonald's is infamously known for a lot of issues, and especially when you have so many people around. So what will happen is they'll go back and, for evidence purposes, they'll pull any video that they have from Canal Street, as well as anyone's cell phone video, and take multiple statements from, number one, the people who were injured, and two, anyone else who saw what was going on.